Hello everyone, I am Meghana P.S. working as an assistant professor in commerce, Government First Grade College, Baramsagra. I am discussing about the subject financial markets and services in that module number 3, regulatory system. In this session, I am discussing about the objectives, responsibilities and powers of SEBI. The objective of this session is to know about the objectives, responsibilities and powers of Securities and Exchange Board of India. And by the end of this session, you are aware about the objectives, responsibilities and powers of SEBI. In the previous session, we discussed about the SEBI. That is, SEBI was formed as a statutory body on April 12th of 1992. SEBI is a regulatory body which controls the securities market and commodities market in India. Why the SEBI was formed in India is because to reduce the malpractices in capital market, the SEBI was established by the government. And the offices, the headquarters was located in Mumbai, and it has 4 regional offices, and in all the major cities it has a local office. And when it comes to structure of SEBI, the SEBI has 9 board members, wherein 1 as a chairman and 9 as 8 as an members of the board. Let's see the objectives of SEBI. The first objective of SEBI is protection to the investors. The SEBI's main objective is to protect the interest of the investors by providing a healthy environment wherein they can flow their savings into the capital market. And the second objective is to prevention of malpractices. As we discussed in the previous session, that is why the SEBI is formed, because to reduce the malpractices in the capital market, SEBI was established. Thus, the main objective of the SEBI is to prevent malpractices such as insider trading, price rigging and manipulation of share prices, etc. And the third one is fair and proper functioning of capital markets. So here the SEBI's one objective is to proper functioning of capital market, wherein it is a regulatory body which controls the capital market. For that purpose, it has to ensure the proper functioning of capital markets by providing rules and regulation, and also it has to regulate the intermediaries to provide the fair functioning of a market. Let's see the responsibilities of SEBI. The first responsibility is to promote the development of securities market and to regulate securities market. So SEBI as a regulatory body for the securities market, its responsibility is to promote and develop the security market, and as well as to lay down the rules and control the securities market. The second one is to protect the interest of investors in securities. By reducing the malpractices in capital market, the SEBI has a responsibility to protect the interest of the investors in securities. Next is to oversee the market operation, organizational structure and administrative control of exchanges. In India, we have various stock exchanges like BSE, NSE. So, the SEBI has a responsibility to look after the organization structure of these exchanges and as well as to control the activities of these exchanges. And the next one is registration and regulation of the working of the intermediaries. In the capital market, we have several intermediaries like brokers, sub-brokers, merchant bankers and so on. So the SEBI has a responsibility to register all these intermediaries as well as to control the working of these intermediaries. And the next one is to prohibit the unfair trade practices in the market. So if there is any malpractices, the SEBI has a responsibility to look after that and to reduce those unfair practices, like insider trading or price rigging. continuation part of responsibilities of SEBI. The next responsibility is that promoting and regulating self-regulatory organization. The self-regulatory organization, for example, AMFI, Association of Mutual Funds in India. So like this, we have several self-regulatory organization. The SEBI has a responsibility to promote, that is to develop these SROs as well as to control these self-regulatory organizations. Next one is to provide education for the investors and give training for the intermediaries. For both, that is the investor who are participating in the capital market, to provide them a education, financial education to them, as well as training to the intermediaries who are involved in the securities market. And the next responsibility of SEBI is to regulate substantial acquisition of shares and to take over of it. The substantial acquisition means acquisition of major portion of shares. By that, the interest of the investors will be reduced. For that reason, the SEBI has to look after the takeovers of the companies as well as substantial acquisition of the shares of the different companies which are listed in the stock exchanges. And the last one is performing such functions and exercising such powers under the provisions of Securities Contracts Regulation Act of 1956 as may be delegated to it by the central government. Means the responsibilities which are laid down in that act, that is Securities Contracts Regulation Act of 1956, all those responsibilities and powers has to be taken care by the SEBI. Let's discuss the powers of SEBI. When it comes to stock exchange, SEBI has a power to regulate and approve any laws related to the stock exchanges. As a regulatory body for the securities market and commodities market, SEBI has a power to control as well as provide laws to the stock exchanges. And the second one is it has a power to access the books of records of stock exchanges, which means the SEBI can go for internal audit of records, and it can also go for periodical checks of the accounts of stock exchanges. Next, it can conduct hearing and pass judgments if there are any malpractices detected on the stock exchange. If there is any unfair practices in the stock exchanges, the SEBI has a power to hear the arguments of parties, and as well as it provides the judgment towards those arguments. Next is when it comes to the treatment of company, the SEBI has a power to list and delist the companies from the stock exchanges. We have several stock exchanges in India, so wherein companies are going to be listed. So the SEBI has a power to get those companies listed as well as delist and remove from the stock exchanges. It has power to list and delist the companies. The next power of SEBI is it has completely regulate all the aspects of insider trading and announces penalties and expulsions if a company is caught doing something unethical. Insider trading in the sense, if someone knows inside information which is unpublished, it is an illegal activity. Because by that information, there is a huge advantage for those persons, and other investors are going to lose from that insider trading. For that purpose, if there are any insider trading in any of the companies, so the SEBI has a power to announce penalties and expulsions, means removing that company if they found they are doing the insider trading. Next, it can also make companies list their shares in more than one stock exchange if it feels that it is beneficial for the investors. So we have several stock exchanges in India. So if SEBI thinks that the investing in those companies are beneficial for the investors, it has a power to list those companies in more than one stock exchange. The next one is SEBI has power to draft legal rules to ensure the protection of general public. Coming to the investor protection, the SEBI has a power to provide legal framework for the protection of general public, that is general investors. And the last one is it has also has a power to regulate the registration of brokers and other middlemen who will deal with the investors in the market. So the persons or middlemen who are dealing with the investors, the SEBI has a control on the registration of those middlemen or brokers. So these are the powers of SEBI. Let's sum up this session. In this session, we discussed about the objectives of SEBI. The main objective of the SEBI is protection of investors, prevention of malpractices, and fair and proper functioning. And we also discussed about the powers and responsibilities provided for SEBI. These are the references for your further readings. I hope you understand the concepts of objectives, responsibilities, and powers of SEBI. Thank you all.